Welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help educate you about narcissistic abuse because your feelings do matter. Hi, and welcome to another podcast of Narc Abuse No More with your host, Dr. and Evangelist, K.O. Rich. Thanks for tuning in today. Today is Wednesday. Yes, it is Wednesday, May the 3rd of 2023. I pray that you've had a blessed, stress-free, narcissistic-free, abuse-free week so far, and that the remainder of this week will continue to be so as well. But if not, we're going to be talking about a few things today. Again, my name is Dr. K.O. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I would like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on the website, you'll find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships, and if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to the website and listen to it from there. Now, just to let you know, we are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and the Tube. That's why we're on YouTube, so you have a variety of different platforms to listen to us from. And if all else fails, all you have to do again is go directly to the website at www.narcabusenomore.org. I also want to make mention to my SoundCloud audience. Right now we're on the free version of SoundCloud, which means that we can upload as many podcasts as we want on that particular one. However, if you would just take a moment to subscribe to an additional sites such as iTunes or YouTube. You can go directly and subscribe to us on YouTube up under Narcissistic Abuse No More. The same image that you see on the SoundCloud version, you will also see as well, just to let you know, to ensure that you're getting the right podcast when you subscribe. And go on YouTube, press the bell. It will alert you as to whenever we post new content. All right, what are we talking about today? We are talking about 15 signs that show someone is a real friend. 15 signs that show someone is a real friend. And I want to extend this into relationships. So I want to say 15 signs to show that someone is real in a relationship. It is so important to know that when you are in a fellowship with someone, if you're in a covenant with someone, a commitment with someone, a friendship with someone, that you have someone that is genuine, someone that's real, someone that's not going to play with your heart. The Bible tells us to guard your heart. And therefore, you don't want someone that's fake, that's phony, that's not going to play with your heart. Many people get into relationships and the other person, you may have the intentions of really having a genuine relationship with that individual, but then the other person is not real. And therefore, you have made deposits. Into an empty bank account that only has holes, okay? So when you invest in a relationship, that's a major investment. That's even a more serious investment than the stock market. You invest in your heart into that relationship. So you want to ensure that you are getting getting equal returns from that, okay? All right. So if you're on that sinking ship, then you need to say, okay, okay, it's time for me to get off this Titanic because it's got an iceberg hit. It's not gonna go anywhere. It's about to sink. Okay, I am sinking in this relationship, so therefore I need to jump and get off board. All right, so we're gonna talk about that today. 15 signs to know that you are in a real relationship, that that person with whom you are in a relationship with is real. And if you're in a relationship with yourself, being solo, I mean, that means that you don't need to be in company with that other person who is not genuine. So number one, when you are in a true relationship, a true friendship with someone, they support you in everything. Now, I'm not talking about something that's illegal, okay, because you got Billy and Clyde's out here or whatever case may be. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about they support your dreams. They support your visions. They support the goals that you have. They support you because their support of you means, hey, especially if you're married or you think about getting married, that your dreams, your visions, your goals is also a uplift for them as well, and vice versa. So you support one another. So if you have someone that you are in a relationship with and they are not supportive of you, they don't want to see you accomplish your dreams, your visions, your, and one thing about narcissists is that they're your competitors, okay? Not that you're trying to compete with them, but they often try to compete with you. So they're not supportive. You can't support someone you're trying to compete against, that you're trying to outdo. So therefore you want someone that's going to be supportive, that's going to support your dreams and visions. And a lot of times when it comes to even whether it's envy or jealousy, you can't be supportive of someone that you're jealous of, someone that you're envious of. So ensure that, hey, you got someone that is not jealous if you succeed or envious of you. They're going to be there cheering you on. And this is even in friendships. If someone, for example, someone you might have two friends and one gets married before the other one. Well, guess what? That friend, if that's a true friend, they're going to be supportive of you as long as you're marrying the right person. Okay. So if you're not, they're going to also be honest with you. But you want that. You need that support. We all need that support. Someone that's going to support you. Number two, they stick with you at your worst. Now, let me just clarify this, okay? Because we're not talking about sticking with someone that's bashing you upside your head, that's cheating, lying, stealing, doing all kind of crazy mess. No. What we're talking about is someone that's there with you during the good times, during the bad times. They share in your success. They also share in your failures, okay? Things that you might say, you know what, I didn't make it the way where I wanted to go. And they're saying, hey, I'm there with you. You know, you may not have succeeded. For example, you may have wanted to get that promotion. You didn't get it. All right. So you're down and about. Okay. They're going to be there with you and say, you know what, maybe next time. Or maybe this is not the, maybe this, you might need to change course. So they're going to be there to support you, even in your successes, even in your failures. They're not going to be just there when you succeed. Like a lottery winner. Oh, I'm there when, because they got some money now. No, they're going to be with you through thick and thin. Again, this is different from saying that I'm holding on to you just because I don't want to be alone and you abusing, misusing, and neglecting me. No, I'm not talking about the toxic type of sticking, trauma bonding or Stockholm syndrome with that. No, I'm talking about being with you even when you're not at your best. For example, when you say your wedding vows for those who are married, and you say through thick and thin, through sickness and health, a ritual for poor, to death do us part. Okay, so you're talking about the better of times and the worst of times, a tale of two cities, the best of times and the worst of times. So they will stick with you at your worst. Number three, they are forgiving, okay? I forgot to give you a website where you can get this valuable information, www.dumblittleman.com, www.dumblittleman.com. All right, so they forgive you for anything. That means that we're all human. We all make mistakes. Sometimes you might say something that you really did not mean. You may have been going through some things, frustrated, whatever the case may be. You all may have had a disagreement or whatever the case may be. But you are forgiving, okay? You all forgive one another. This is not that, oh, he hit me upside my head and knocked me out and beat me to a pulp, but I'm going to forgive him and go back into the relationship because he said that, oh, he loves me and he cares for me and he wants me to be with him and he didn't mean it. He was going, no. We're not endorsing abuse on this particular podcast, okay? We do not endorse abuse. I'm of the belief that you hit me once, that will be the last time, okay? Because I am out, all right? No, you know, I forgive you from a distance. You will not get a chance to redo it. There will be no retakes. I'm talking about a healthy relationship, okay? Healthy relationship where you all forgive one another, because when you get into this relationship, whether it's a romantic relationship, whether it is a friendship, there's going to be times where you're going to have to forgive one another. And so don't be the type where I'm holding grudges and even after I say I forgive you, I'm throwing it back up every 5 seconds, whatever case may be. No, we have to have that forgiving spirit. Why? Because God forgives us, and so therefore God tells us to forgive others because he forgives us. Number four, they always have your back. Let me just say this. When it comes to couples, okay, you might disagree. Agree with one another, have each other back in public, and you might disagree behind closed doors, and that's the way it should be. Have each other's back, all right? That person should be able to rely on you. This is how you know if you have someone that's genuine in your life. They're going to stick up for you. They're going to be there for you. Now, I'm not talking about someone sticking up for you in you're wrong, okay? Because when you're wrong, you're wrong. I don't care if you're blood, whatever the case may be. If you're wrong, you're wrong. But when it comes to marriage couples, I'm going to say support each other in public. And then if you disagree about something, do it behind closed doors, okay? But have each other's back in the forefront. This is not being fake. This is just saying, you know what? You might be saying, I don't agree with you on this, but I'm going to have your back. But I'm going to tell you behind closed doors. Now, that one cool or whatever case may be, or there's a way to agree to disagree, especially if you are a married couple. So you have each other's back. A real friend will stand by your side no matter what, but at the same time, a real friend will not participate in your wrong nor help you to do wrong, but they will be there for you. For example, you may go rob a bank. Please don't. Okay, you may go rob a bank and you might be friends with somebody. They're not going to help you rob that bank because then there'll be a co-conspirator, okay, or accomplice to it, all right? But if you get locked up, they're not going to, if they're a true friend, they're not going to end their friendship. They're going to say, you know what, you know you were dead wrong, okay? But I'm still your friend, but I'm going to let you know you're wrong, but I will right you when you go, you know, while you behind the prison cell at the same time you were wrong. So they'll have your back, but they're not going to participate in your wrong, but they will also tell you when you're wrong, all right? So they will rebuke you, they will correct you. They're not going to participate in the action, but they will do it out of love. They will correct you and even rebuke you out of love. Number five, they will keep in touch. Now, this one is, I'm going to say this. Sometimes people, you might be living in a different state, a different town, whatever the case may be. But you're going to find at some point that you're going to connect with that person, whether it's a text, hey, I'm thinking about you, a message. Sometimes I might not talk to somebody for years over the phone, but I'll send a message. I just did this recently with a friend of mine, and I haven't talked to her in a long time, but I sent her a message, a private message on social media. I said, hey, you know, I'm thinking about you. How you doing? Blah, 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 or whatever the case may be. I have another friend. She lives in Washington, away. I haven't seen her in years, okay? But every now and then, you know, whether it's a Christmas card, whether it's a text or a phone call, you know, it might be once a year, but your true friends, even if you're not in contact with one another all the time, it will still be that love, that relationship that's there. It's nothing to say that, oh, well, you know, I don't care about you. You may not talk all the time, because sometimes, you know, we live busy lives and you can't always talk to someone all the time. However, just, you know, even if it's once a year, just to say, you know what, you're on my mind. That's what a genuine friendship is. All right, we're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Oh,
That's what friends are for, and that is by Dionne Warwick and Friends. That's what friends are for. All right, so we're still continuing on 15 signs that show someone is a real friend or is genuine in that relationship. So I believe we're at number six, and they keep your secrets. Now, let me just say this. You have some people that mean well, but they got loose lips. And as that saying go, loose lips sink ships, okay? That means you can't have anybody divulging your location, your geographical. Just think if you was in the military and y'all on a, y'all doing this undercover operation or this secretive operation, and you got someone on the ship that's telling everybody your location, your I forget what they call that. But basically they give them the coordinates. Yeah, the coordinates of where you're at and all that. Hey, the enemy can send something and knock you out the water, okay? So the thing is, you need someone that is going to keep your confidence, okay? A true person will keep your confidence. And not only will they keep your confidence, they will not use it against you. Now, we often talk about this when you're dealing with narcissists, all right? You have the right to remain silent. Amanda Rice. Okay, I think it's Amanda Rice. Miranda Rice. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of the narcissist. That means whatever you tell them, your vulnerabilities, whatever it is, they will put it in a vault and take it out and to use it on you later. This means that you have to watch what you say when you're dealing with people that are not genuine, because they will use it against you. It will be the next news, okay? It will be the next day's gossip, maybe that same day gossip, as soon as you get off the phone with them. Did you hear that such and such, or whatever the case may be? So a person who is genuine, genuine in the relationship, they're not going to go and tell what they know about you. And even if there's a disagreement, you all fall out, they're still going to keep that confidence. Now, one of the reasons that divorces are often nasty is because you have two people that know just about everything about the other individual, the good, the bad, the ugly. All right. And so therefore, they will use it against that individual. So you want to make sure that you are in a genuine relationship with someone with whom you can keep confidence with. That means that whatever it is, your vulnerabilities, your secrets, even your dreams, goals, and aspirations, because you can't tell that to everybody, all right? So a genuine person will be able to keep confidence. Number seven, they make time for you. Now, we all live busy lives. I know I do. And so, therefore, I'm not always able to be on the phone. I'm not always able to be around, you know, other people, whatever the case may be. However, when you want to make time for someone, you will. It may not always be every day, every week, not even every month, as I mentioned before. Some friends I have, I may talk to them once or twice a year, but at some point you will make time for those that you care about, those that are important to you. And when you're dealing with a narcissist, however, a narcissist is all about themselves. They make time when they want to make time. It's never about you. It's always about them. So this is something to keep in mind when you're dealing with narcissistic type of individuals. Number eight, they are loyal and faithful. When you're dealing with someone that is genuine, they're not going to be listening to someone else run you down, or someone that's going to be shaming you, or whatever the case may be. They're going to be a loyal friend. They're not going to be fair weather friends. When things are good, they're there. When things are not, they're gone. They're not going to betray you. You're going to be able to trust them. You're going to be able to be in fellowship with them and know that that your friendship is solid. And that needs to be understood on both sides, okay? When you're in a relationship with someone, you want someone that's not going to be going around with every other body, okay? You don't want someone that's community property. You want someone that's going to be faithful and loyal to you. And let me just say this to those who have not gotten married yet. If the person is cheating on you before you get with them, they're going to cheat on you afterwards, okay? If they can't stay faithful to you, then guess what? You do not need them. You can do better. You have to love yourself more. You have to say, you know what? I deserve to have someone that's going to be 100% committed to me, not committed to me and then everybody else in the community. So they're going to be loyal. They're going to be faithful. Number 9. They do not ridicule you in public. This is one of the things that narcissists would do on the sidelines, okay? And we talked about this a couple of weeks ago, where you will have a narcissist that will make comments. It's called dog whispering, okay? They will make comments that only you know about, but then everybody else is oblivious to everybody else. It's just like that whistle. They have one even for deer, where the deer hear the sounds of the whistle, but no one else does. And so they get that signal, and it actually keeps them away. You could put them on your cars. If you're going at a certain speed for deer, they'll hear it. And so it keeps them from running into your vehicle. So it's the same way with when it comes to the dog whistle. The person that is trying to signal something to you in a way that no one else would know, then they'll do what's called dog whistle. So therefore, if, for example, if they know you're sensitive about your weight, then they may make a comment and say, oh, well, he loves a lot of cake. He loves cake. Now, you know, and they know that they're talking about you. Everybody else will say, oh, yeah, I love cake, too. But they will not get it. But the person that you are that you're targeting, or the other person that's being the target of that particular sarcasm, should I say, they will know exactly what you're saying. So they're not going to ridicule you in public. They're not going to even do it in to humiliate you or to mock you or to shame you. A person that's genuine will try to protect your reputation. They will try to protect your feelings. They will be mindful of those things. But when you're dealing with a narcissist, they will not care. I believe we're at, let me make sure, because this isn't exactly numbered, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Number 10, they are open to you. A real person will discuss things openly with you and not hide their feelings. They will feel that they can trust you. They will be open, even, you know, if they think that it might be a sensitive topic, just so you all can have that that honesty with one another. So they will not do things, or they will not be misleading to you. They will not be disloyal. They will not lie to you. They will care about how you feel, and therefore they will not try to do things that will compromise the relationship. And it's so important for people to be honest with one another, whether you're in a friendship, whether it's a intimate relationship with this person. You say, okay, we're dating and we're getting ready to get married, or whatever the case may be. Honesty is key, because once that trust is broken, it is hard to get back. And people don't just outright deserve your trust, all right? Trust is earned, all right? Trust is earned. Therefore, do not just throw your heart into everybody's lap. Allow that person to build trust with you. That relationship needs time to build the trust and not just give it. All right, we're going to take another quick break, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Count me through thick and thin. A friendship I will never end. When you are weak, I will be strong. Helping you to carry. Call on me, I will be there. the sunshine through the rain. Oh, I know sometimes it seems as if it's never
Houston and CC whining, and you need someone that you can count on. All right, so we're continuing on. Number 11. They keep their promises. When you're with someone that is genuine, whether it's a friendship, an intimate relationship, they keep their promises to you. You know, no one likes someone that make promises and they don't keep them. When you're dealing with the narcissist, they will not keep their word. They will also gaslight you to make you think that, oh, they didn't say what they said, that they or whatever the case may be. So they're not able to be trusted. But when you're in a genuine relationship, they know that their word is their bond. So therefore, when you want a sincere relationship, you have to know and you want and should expect that person to be a person of their word. I don't like when people say, oh, I'm gonna do something, and then they don't do it, or either they dodge and don't even say, you know what, I can't do it, or whatever have you, with the expectation that they're gonna do something that they're not. So make sure that if you're in this relationship with someone, make sure it's someone that keeps their word, keeps their promises. Number 12, they are trustworthy. Okay. And it also goes back to keeping promises. If you can't trust someone to keep their word, then that trust is broken. So a person that is genuine in the relationship, they're a person that you can trust. If you're with someone and they have shown you that they're not trustworthy, then guess what? No matter how long you stay in that relationship, that trust would never be there, which means that it's not much of a relationship when you can't trust the person that you're with. Again, trust is earned, okay? It's not to be just freely given. Trust has to be earned. And when that person breaks that trust, it's hard to earn it back. Not to say it's not possible, but both parties will have to work together for that trust to be earned. And it can't be just the one person. And the one person that did break the trust is the one that's most responsible for making sure that that trust is reestablished. Number 13, they know and understand you. When you have a relationship with someone that is genuine, they're going to take the time to get to know you. They're going to take the time to get to understand you. They're going to want to always have the relationship growing and thriving and getting to know you and vice versa. So they're going to try to be understanding. Again, when you're dealing with a narcissist, they're not thinking about anyone else but themselves in the relationship. And even if they try to understand, it's more than likely for them to use it as a form or a tool of manipulation to get what they want. Not that they're concerned about you, but it's all about them. Number 14, they remember things about you. This is someone that's genuine. They're taking time to understand you. They wanting to get to know you. They're going to remember maybe your birthday. Now, I'm going to admit this. I am bad when it comes to remembering exact dates when it comes to birthdays. I normally get the month, but you ask me the exact day, I'm not going to remember. I even get the season, but... I'll get around the season. So your birthday may be in February. I might think it's January. You know, it depends on how many people I'm trying to remember. But the thing is that person is going to remember certain things about you, whether it's anniversaries, especially if you're in a romantic relationship with this person, that person is going to try to get to know you. All right, so moving on. They think about you. We're at number 15. They think about you before themselves. And this is so important for, you know, when you're thinking about a narcissist, you're thinking about someone who always thinks about themselves first and everyone else last, or what they can get out of someone before they discard them. But when you're in a genuine relationship, you want to think about the other person. And this is different than just being a people pleaser. Now, we don't want to get this confused. People pleasers, when you're dealing with someone that's narcissistic, abusive, or toxic individual, you're thinking about someone that's going to take advantage of someone else. But so you don't want to be a people pleaser where that person never appreciates, values, or even considers your feelings or think about you. But when you're in a mutually respected relationship, a genuine friendship, a genuine relationship with someone, you're one someone that's going to be thinking of you as well as your well-being. They're not going to just think about what I can get out of this relationship, but they're never thinking about you. You want someone that's caring, someone that's loving, someone that's interested in your well-being, someone that would sacrifice for you just like you would for them. At the end of the day, you want to be in the relationships and have people around you that are equally invested in the relationship as you are. So therefore, it's not where it's one-sided, not where the person doesn't care about you and it's all you're the one that's giving. They're just taking. The relationship is there's both parties equally involved. I don't say a 50-50 in the relationship. It should be 100-100. 50-50 means I'm only giving half. 100-100 means I'm giving all my all to this relationship. And the reason that I went over these tips today is because so many people are in a relationship where there is nothing but holes. They're investing everything into this relationship, but there is no return on the investment. And therefore, they're being emotionally depleted, spiritually depleted. They're drained emotionally, and you don't want to be drained in a relationship. A relationship should be fulfilling. It should be mutual respect, mutual honesty, mutual trust, communication. These are things that are important in a relationship. But if you're the only one that's contributing to the relationship in a positive manner, then you're always going to be on the downside of the seesaw, because it is going to be a seesaw. There's never going to be a balance on that seesaw, because it's always going to be where you're the one that's down and you're weighed down by the weights. Speaking of weights, I want to just remind you all that I will be I'm editing the second edition of The Weight of Weights, the book I put out in 2014. There's going to be a second edition out, preferably by either the end of this month or sometime in June. And it's called The Weight of Weights. And I will let you all know when you will be able to get that book on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Lulu.com, and other outlets. There are so many people that's carrying tons of weight, and we want to be able to free those weights. Release those weights that are holding you back and keeping you from being fulfilled in your life. And for many, it's dealing with getting rid of the weight of narcissism. Get those narcissistic individuals out of your life so that you can thrive and excel without having to be bowed down with excessive weights. All right, we are out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you, and that you would know your feelings, they do matter. This is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, helping you to admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse. Until next time.